Morning, students. How are you all? Very nice. It's so long. Good morning, students. Okay, we'll continue with our fourth lecture. In today's lecture, we will continue with the next part. What is the next part? Is lightning. Okay, in this part of lightning, we will study how the lightning occurs, how it is formation is there, what are the nature of after lightning, that is lightning strokes, how does it, what impact does it create, any destruction, is it any of useful, and how to protect us from ourselves from it. Okay, yes, so we'll start first about how a lightning is formed. Okay, students, so write the heading lightning, and we will in today's lecture we'll just cover about lightning. Okay, okay, so just write in the lightning. First of all, let me ask you one question. You can type me in the comment box. Okay, why does lightning occur? This is just a basic question. Why does lightning occur and who causes it? Okay, these are the two questions you are supposed to answer in the comments. Okay, did you find the answer? Yes. Okay, let us discuss how the lightning forms. Okay, yes, now lightning. See, this is rainy season. In rainy season, what happens? All through, you know, all through the day, sun keeps on throwing out and its energy in the form of heat to us on our land. And on land, what happens? On land, what happens, students? Due to the constant heating, land gets heated up and water bodies on the land gets vaporized. They get vaporized, and these vapors travel above. As you know, the water cycle. Yes, and these water vapors accumulate in the form of cloud. And students, what happens is that when these water vapors accumulate high up in the sky, water vapors accumulate high up in the sky. These water vapors have many water molecules in it, and these water molecules, when the temperature gets very low at the high altitude, its temperature gets very, very low, they get condensed. Condensed means what? The water vapor slowly get in the form of water droplets. Yes, in the form of water droplets. And when these water droplets are formed in huge clouds, what happens? They keep on constantly moving. Yes, water droplets, they keep on constantly moving. And when, because the temperature is also very low, they get solidified also sometimes in the form of small ice particles also many times. Okay, what is there in the clouds? First of all, water vapor. Okay, after condensation, what do they become? They become water droplets, and also sometimes ice particles. Okay, ice particles. And you have just studied in our static charge that when these charges, okay, when these materials are rubbed upon each other, like we had one plastic scale rubbed upon another. So what happens when rubbing is done? When rubbing is done, what happens? Yes, when rubbing is done, constantly electrons jump over. Yes, they get charged. Charge means what? They develop positive and negative. Yes, and due to this property of these charges, due to this constant rubbing, the material acquires a new property called as charge. Due to why? Because we are rubbing it. So these particles are formed so much that they also start rubbing over each other. They also start rubbing over each other. Water droplets, ice particles, all the other particles, heavy. There are many particles in clouds, right? Different gases are there. All the particles, they are constantly rubbing each other. Now, because they are very light, they tend to lose their electron and become charged. Yes, and they become charged. Okay, students, why? Which thing become charged? Which easily lose their electrons or which easily acquire electrons. Okay, that we have studied, that we'll study deep in chemistry. So first we have to understand that any particle, like lighter particles, okay, there are some lighter particles. Okay, lighter particles, okay, and heavy particles. Yes, lighter particles of the clouds move up, heavy particles move down. Lighter particles in the gases, there, which particles? These particles might be water vapors, condensation, water droplets, different gases, okay, many other particles, etc. Yes, these are made up of clouds are made up of number of particles. So lighter particles lose electrons, and whenever they lose electrons, they become positively charged. Yes, they become positively charged. And then what happens? Heavy particles tend to accept electrons and they become negatively charged. And this is what how charges are formed in a cloud. Okay. Now these charges are formed so much, then when there are many such charges formed, when the cloud accumulates bigger and bigger and bigger, heavier charges keeps on accumulating. And when heavy charges keeps on accumulating, this charge becomes more and more powerful. Yes, more and more charges. It's just like compressing of spring. What happens when you compress a spring? After you release it, comes. It releases. So what happens? Many charges are compressed. Compressed. And so much what happens after some time, this becomes highly negative charged. Okay, the cloud becomes highly negatively charged at the bottom, and at the top it becomes highly positively charged. Okay. After some time, what happens? After constantly rubbing, it becomes highly positive charged, and this becomes highly negatively charged. Yes. And after some time, what happens due to this difference? The ground is there here. Okay, the ground is there. And what happens to the ground is, okay, this is negative. What does negative want? Negative wants to attract positive. So in ground, there are all the ground is material. It is always made up of positive, negative together. So what happens is that this negative wants to attract positive. So the ground pulls the positive surface on the surface of the earth. So this move away upside. All the positive charges from the ground move above. Okay. So what happens is that the surface ground becomes positively charged. And now when the surface is positively charged, what happens is that there is a difference. There is a difference in the positive and negative. And what happens in positive and negative? These charges, because of constant rubbing, they try to get highly negative, and this becomes highly positive. Now what happens if there is a conductor in between? What would happen if there is a metal wire? If I connect a wire, so what would happen? This negative charge would come and this positive charge would come, and they would meet each other. Yes, they would meet each other, and we would say that the charges have discharged. When you put a wire. But students, we do not need a wire. We do not need any wire for this discharge. Why, you know, students? Because the air molecules which are there in between the cloud and the ground, becomes, due to this difference in charge, it becomes a good conductor for a while. Means what? There are some ions in air, which allow, they allow the charges to flow. This is very important. What do the ions do? They allow the charges to flow. And when they allow the charges to flow, like for example, there are certain materials. Okay, then what happens? These charges try to reach. There is a certain another material here, which is also ionized. So this travels in the form of, these particles travels in the form of this path. Okay, through the ions. Ions are nothing but what? Ions are nothing but particles in the air. Okay, charged particles in air. Okay, the charged particles in air allow the charges to flow, and this flow is called as discharging. This process is called as discharge. Thus, a cloud which has got highly negative charge by constantly moving gets finally discharged. And when this finally discharge happens, all the huge energy, it comes down on the ground in all of one stroke only. Why? Because, yes, you know, when you compress a spring too much and you release, finally what happens? It comes down with huge energy, right? So that is how when you, many electrons, many charges are compressed so much, so that finally when it gets certain path, it comes down with large amount of energy in one stroke only. This energy includes heat. It includes light, and yes, also it includes sound. which is very important. This heat, light and sound is energy is coming in these three forms. Energy is coming in these three forms. Which energy? Yes, the energy that was stored due to charge. Energy that was stored due to charge. So energy is coming out in the form of heat energy, light energy and sound energy. Initially it was only electrostatic energy. Which energy it was there? First, initially it was only, let us call this energy of compression of charge, it's called as electrostatic energy. Yes, the electrostatic energy of the compressed charges now releases into the form of heat energy, light energy and sound energy. And this energy release is so dangerous that it can harm the property, it can harm the life. Is it not, students? Yes, so we need to take precaution from this. It is very dangerous. So we have developed certain processes to safeguard ourselves from this. First of all, let us talk more about these lightnings. Okay, this causes a temperature. Whenever it heats up, it travels. The temperature created here is 50,000 degrees. How many? 50,000 degrees. 50,000 degrees in sun, the temperature is 5,000 degrees. So it is approximately 10 times stronger than sun. So dangerous the lightning is. Yes, students, isn't it? So we need to be safeguarded from this. So what are the processes that we'll learn after some time? Yes. Okay. So we learned about how the lightning occurs. Lightning occurs, water vapors, clouds, clouds due to motion, due to constant rubbing. Yes. Clouds when constantly rub, what happens? Friction, losing electrons, get charged up. And when get charged, charge builds up. And after charge builds up, huge charges are getting built up. Okay. With accumulation, huge charges build up. Yes, huge charges build up. And when huge charges are built up at same point, what it needs? It needs to be released, right? Like a spring is compressed. What does it need? It needs to be released. But there should be certain path to get released. And who is this path here? These are the ions. These are the ions in the air that allow this charge to flow into the earth. And this is called as lightning discharge. Okay, students, it is very interesting and you have learned the word called lightning discharge, isn't it? Yes, it is coming out in the form of heat, light and sound. Very good. Yes. Okay. Now we will go to, now is it any useful? We have learned that it is harmful. Yes, it is harmful for life. Is it any useful lightning? Some students might say, sir, so much of energy is created. Can you store that energy and use in the form of electricity? Yes, it is a nice idea. One student has asked, but this energy is so high that we haven't discovered any technique to trap it. If you have discovered, if you are a young scientist, if you have any idea, then please let us know. Okay, good. Now we will see how to protect ourselves. So now see, if a person would come in between or any life would come, it would have harmed that life. But now, in order to safeguard ourselves from this lightning, we can allow, if a person is there here and he wants to get protected, what he can do is he can allow a good conductor here. Okay, a good conductor. Now what this good conductor will do? This good conductor will allow this all lightning to go into the earth. Yes, and the person will be saved. So this good conductor has to be very, very high, right? And this, putting this good conductor or keeping, arranging this good conductor is nothing but called as lightning arrester. It's called as lightning arrester. Okay. So we'll see what is lightning arrester. In a building where you have built up your houses. So here at the building top, there is a lightning arrester. What do we call it? Lightning
arrestor.
Now, what is lightning arrestor do? There are certain spikes over it. Okay, there are certain spikes. It is made up of metal. It is made up of copper, especially copper. So what happens when there is cloud lightning here? Okay, between the, in the clouds there is lightning. So what happens? This lightning, instead of going anywhere, it comes, it gets attracted to this metal. Why? Because metal is a good conductor. Metal is a good conductor. Electric charges will flow where? Will flow where they are attracted more, and electrons get attracted to good conductors. So instead of going anywhere else, they get attracted to this metal, and which is mainly of copper, which is mainly of copper metal. Okay, and when it is getting attracted, this is allowed to pass in through a copper metallic strip into the earth, and inside the earth there is a huge plate. And what does this plate do? This plate is kept inside the ground, and there is coal. What is there here, students? Coal. Coal means, you know, yes, in Marathi you say kolsa. Coal. What does it do? It easily discharges the charges into the ground. Okay, it easily discharges. Okay, all the negative charges, it easily passes onto the ground, and everything is again zero or normal state. Okay, what happens whenever there is lightning? See, lightning always occurs from the cloud to the ground. There is one more form of lightning when there are two clouds away from each other. And suppose, let us say here there is positive and here there is positive of one charge and negative of another charge. So lightning occurs in this way also. This is called as intercloud lightning. What we are talking about is cloud to ground lightning. This is for our syllabus. In our syllabus, we are talking about cloud to ground lightning, but there also exists intercloud lightning, which is there, which is not there for your syllabus. Cloud to cloud, one cloud to another cloud, that is called as intercloud lightning. And there is one more cloud lightning. What is that? Intracloud lightning. Means what? Within the one cloud itself, there are huge charges accumulated, then they get discharged in the same cloud. You must have seen in movies or in any while they shoot any natural phenomena. Do you see in space lightning is going on within the cloud? Yes, sometimes cloud to cloud, within one cloud only lightning happens. So that is intra cloud. This is intra cloud lightning. Yes, students, intercloud lightning and cloud to ground lightning that we are studying here. Now, what happens? These metal spikes which are there to safeguard ourselves. What is the use of lightning arrestor? Lightning arrestor is used to do what? To safeguard. Yes, it is used to safeguard. Safeguard us of what? Property, life, to safeguard our property, that is buildings, to protect life, that is humans, cattle, all the things and all. Okay, so to safeguard all the life also, we need this lightning arrestor. Okay, what does it do? It protects us from lightning. It easily allows the lightning to get discharged into the ground. Okay, this coal plates, what do they do? This coal and plate, there is a metal plate and coal is also there. What does it do? It easily discharges the lightning into the ground. Okay, this is lightning arrestor. Okay, these spikes easily attract the lightning charges and easily travel passes them into the ground. This is a metal sphere. Instead of falling anywhere else, the electric charges, they are getting attracted to the good conductor metal, and metal easily allows them to pass through the ground. So what should be done? It should not be touched, because it should it has got this huge amount of energy. It is very, very harmful. So what we should do? Okay, what are the things that you should protect yourselves? Alexander Fleming was a person who had discovered that. Alexander Fleming, who had also discovered the charge, also discovered lightning arrestor. Lightning arrestor was discovered by Alexander Fleming. Okay, yes. So what we were going to talk about is next thing to do to safeguard ourselves, what we have done. Yes, first of all, we have produced lightning arrester. Then we have certain do's and don'ts. We have certain do's and don'ts. So what are these do's and don'ts? Okay, well, let us see any uses of lightning. Because of this huge energy, there is nitrogen in surrounding. There is also hydrogen in surrounding. But for plants, you need nitrogenous compound. So what happens due to lightning, due to huge amount of lightning, what happens is nitrogen and hydrogen come together and they form NH3. Okay, let's balance it. Okay, so ammonia is formed, which is a good nitrogenous compound, and this compound is useful as a fertilizer, it is there in soil. So it is useful in certain way. Lightning helps this to form ammonia compounds. Also, one more thing is that oxygen is added up to form ozone due to lightning. What happens? Oxygen molecules and different oxygen molecules fuse together somehow and they form this new oxygen. This is called as ozone. Okay, we need ozone layer in our space to protect ourselves from the harmful ultraviolet rays. Yes, so this ozone is built up in atmosphere due to lightning. So lightning is so useful in some way. Okay, now in order to protect ourselves, we need to safeguard ourselves. So what we have devised is, we have certain do's and certain don'ts. Okay, so we'll see what are those do's and don'ts. Do's, and we have certain don'ts. So what are do's and what are don'ts? First of all, if you have lightning, you must have been either inside your house, either or you have been outside. So when you are inside, in order to protect yourselves, yes, inside the house you should find, first of all, let us form a table, good table, in your notebook also. So inside your house, you don't need to do anything. You are already safe. Yes. What you can do still inside house, protect yourselves. You should move away from the windows. Yes. Should get at the center of the your house. Okay. Move at a safe place. Inside house, move at a safer place. Inside a building, if you are there, so move at a safer place. What you should not do inside your house? You should not touch the electrical cables. You should switch off the lights. Yes, switch off the electrical appliances. Okay, should not touch the cables. You should not touch near the walls. Okay, do not touch the walls. What else you can do? You should not go to a running water. Avoid in contact with running water. And what else you can do? You should not give on mobile. Okay. Avoid contact with what? Wired telephones. These all things you should not do when you are inside a house, inside a building. Outside a building, what you can do is, you should sit down, you should squat low. That diagram is given in textbook. Squat low, okay, sit down. Okay, sit down. If you are then find shelter under low trees. Low trees. Do not, because high trees get easily attracted, okay, to the lightning, right?
Okay.
So outside of home, what you cannot do is, what you should not do outside, avoid umbrellas. Hmm?
Avoid umbrellas. If you are then, avoid umbrellas. No umbrellas. Okay, let us see. Avoid umbrellas. And what you can do is,
what you can avoid? Avoid shelter under high trees. And you can add up your own list. Okay, all the students. Okay, today's homework is write a proper summary on lightning. How lightning is formed. Today's proper summary is how a lightning is formed. So you have to basically start from the water molecules rise up, accumulate, they get build up, and finally when it is too much, it gets released because there is certain ions in the air that allow the charged into the ground. Okay, so this process, what happens, who invented, all this in short summary, your notes you have to send me, and your subject teachers, as well as you have to form the table of do's and don'ts. Okay, students, so let us meet. Okay, thank you.